This video discusses multi-stage decision problems. The introductory example we have considered is a single-stage decision problem. As the company only needs to make one decision, what size of apartment complex they should build? In practice, a lot of decision problems are much more complicated than this example and may involve multiple decisions for the decision maker to make. Let's consider a revised version of the example. Instead of assuming all three states of nature, strong, medium, and weak demands are all equally likely, the company could hire a market research firm to assess the likelihood of the market demand. If a favorable or optimistic report is received, the probabilities of a strong demand, medium demand, and a weak demand are 50%, 35%, and 15% respectively. On the other hand, if an unfavorable report is received, these probabilities would change to 5%, 30%, and 65%. The company believes that there is almost the same chance of getting a favorable or unfavorable report, 55% versus 45%. The cost of conducting a market research is $100,000. This report changes the outlook and may impact the company's decision on the size of the complex to build. What is the optimal strategy? Should the company conduct market research? There are two decisions faced by the company. First, conduct market research or not. Second, which apartment complex to build? Let's start building this tree using precision tree. When we build a tree in precision tree, we start from the left to the right. The first decision would be whether they should carry out a market research. This is a decision node, so we draw a square here. There are two alternatives, yes versus no. So there are two branches coming out of this node. We consider the easier alternative first, that's not to conduct market research. When a company decides not to conduct market research, then we follow the no path to reach the next decision node, where the company needs to decide on the size of the apartment complex. If you think carefully about this problem, the rest of the decision tree is identical to the decision tree in our original single-stage decision problem. Instead of creating the tree step by step, we could just copy and paste the subtree at this node. This is how it looks like after we have done that. If the company follows this path, then its expected payoff is $3.03 million when it builds a medium complex for the second decision. Can a company do any better if it conducts market research? This time, we consider the situation where the company decides to carry out the market research. So that's going to be the yes path. Well, this market research costs $100,000, we would have to modify the first decision node. We now take the yes path to reach a chance node where the company waits for the outcome of this report. The outcome is uncertain. It could be a favorable report, it could also be an unfavorable report. There is a 55% chance of getting a favorable report versus 45% chance of getting an unfavorable report. Let's focus on a node after getting a favorable report. This would be a decision node where the company decides on the size of the apartment complex. The tree structure to the right of this decision node would be identical to the tree in the single-stage example. The only difference would be the probabilities under the strong, medium, and weak demand are now different. This is because we have received a favorable market report. Again, we can copy and paste the subtree at this node, and then revise the probabilities correspondingly. Please pause the video here and review the probabilities and cash flows to the right of this decision node. The tree structure after an unfavorable report is also identical to the original single-stage example. Again, the probabilities are different and needed to be revised. Please pause the video here and examine the payoffs and cash flows. Now we have completed this decision tree. This is the final tree structure with two decisions that a decision maker has to make. This tree diagram is too small to be displayed properly on one screen. Let's zoom in to the recommended strategy that's labeled as true at the decision nodes. We could let precision tree to show us the recommended strategy by clicking on decision analysis, policy suggestion, then looking at the optimal tree tab. Here is what the optimal tree looks like. Based on the EMV rule, the company is recommended to conduct market research. If it receives a favorable report, then the company is recommended to build a large complex. But if it receives an unfavorable report, it is recommended to build a small complex. By following this recommendation, the company expects a payoff of $3.78 million. Recall that, without market research, the highest payoff this company gets is $3.03 million. The decision tree also shows the expected payoff, that is EMV, at every stage of the decision problem. At the very first decision node, if the company follows the recommended strategy, the EMV is $3.78 million. But its expected payoff increases to $4.5 million after receiving a favorable report, and reduces to $2.9 million after receiving an unfavorable report. The payoffs of the six terminal nodes also present a risk profile. For example, if the company ends up at the very first terminal node, that is after conducting market research, receiving a favorable report, and building a large complex, but the demand is weak, then the payoff is negative $3.6 million. The probability of this event is 8.25%. The total probability of getting a payoff of $2.9 million is 20.25% plus 13.5% plus 2.25%. That's a total of 45%. The highest payoff the company could expect is $8.4 million with a probability of 27.5%. Please pause the video here and see if you can read the decision tree and find other payoff amounts and their associated probabilities. This also concludes the video where we learn to build and solve a decision problem that involves multiple decisions.